हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम संजना कवटगी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, AITM, बेलगावी. लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द वीडियो लेक्चर्स ऑन स्टोरेज एरिया नेटवर्क्स. वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द मॉड्यूल नंबर 1 इन दिस वीडियो. लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर डेटा सेंटर एनवायरमेंट. लेट अस सी द कनेक्टिविटी पार्ट हियर. Connectivity refers to the interconnection between host or between a host and peripheral devices. What are peripheral devices? Such as printers or storage devices, basically input output and additional devices that you are going to connect with the system. So the discussion here focuses only on the connectivity between the host and the storage device. So we will be seeing only the explanation about host and the storage device. Connectivity and communication between host and storage device are enabled using physical components and interface protocols. Let us see the physical components of a connectivity. The physical components of connectivity are the hardware elements that connect the host to the storage. Three physical components of the connectivity between the host and the storage storage are the host interface device, port, and the cable. You can see it in the figure. Host interface device or host adapter connects a host to the other host and storage devices. Examples of host interface devices are the host bus adapter, that is HBA, and network interface card, that is NIC. Host bus adapter is an application specific integrated circuit, that is ASIC, that is application specific integrated circuit board, that performs I/O interface functions between the host and the storage, relieving the CPU from additional I/O processing workload. A host typically contains multiple HBAs. Okay, so next is port. A port is specialized outlet that enables connectivity between the host and the external devices. An HBA may contain one or more ports to connect the host to other storage devices. Next is the cable. Cable connects the host to the internal or external devices using copper or fiber optic media. Let us see the interface protocols. A protocol enables communication between the host and the storage. Protocols are implemented using the interface devices or controllers at both source as well as destination. The popular interface protocols used for host-to-storage communication are Integrated Device Electronics / Advanced Technology Attachment, that is IDE/ATA, Small Computer System Interface (SCSI), and Fiber Channel (FC) and Internet Protocol (IP). Let us understand all these protocols. The first one is Integrated Device Electronics / Advanced Technology Attachment, that is IDE/ATA. Okay, so IDE/ATA, this is a popular interface protocol standard used for connecting storage devices such as disk drives and CD-ROMs, CD-ROM drives. Okay, so this protocol supports parallel transmission and therefore is also known as parallel ATA, that is PATA, or simply ATA. Okay, IDE/ATA, this protocol has a variety of standards and names. The Ultra DMS/133 version of ATA supports a throughput of 133 MB per second. So the data transfer occurs at 133 MB per second. In a master-slave configuration, an ATA interface supports two storage devices per connector. However, the performance of the drive is important. Sharing a port between two devices is not so recommended. Okay. Next we have is the serial version of this protocol that supports single bit serial transmission and is known as serial ATA. So high performance and low cost SATA has largely replaced PATA in newer systems. SATA revision of 3.0 provides a data transfer rate up to 6 GB per second. So in the previous parallel transmission we had throughput of 133 MB per second, but whereas in case of serial ATA we can get throughput up to 6 GB per second. You can see the difference in the throughput. So SATA has almost replaced the PATA in the newer system. The next protocol we have is SESI and Serial SESI. SESI has emerged as a preferred connectivity protocol in high-end computers. This protocol supports parallel transmission and offers improved performance, scalability, and compatibility compared to ATA. However, the high cost associated with SESI limits its popularity among home or personal desktop users. Over the years, SESI has been enhanced and now includes a wide variety of related technologies and standards. SESI supports up to 16 devices on a single bus and provides data transfer rates up to 640 MB per second for the Ultra 640 version. Next is the Serial Attached SESI, that is SAS. It is a point-to-point serial protocol that provides an alternative to parallel SESI. So the newer version of Serial SESI, that is SAS 2.0, supports a data transfer rate up to 6 GB per second. So again, same here also, SESI has almost replaced parallel SESI, and this also provides this data transfer rate up to 6 GB per second. The next protocol we have is Fiber Channel. Fiber Channel is a widely used protocol for high-speed communication to the storage device. So the Fiber Channel interface provides gigabyte network speed. It provides a serial data transmission that operates over copper wire and optical fiber. The latest version of FC interface, that is 16FC, allows the transmission of data up to 16 GB per second. The FC protocol and its features are covered more in the upcoming chapters. We shall study the connectivity and various components of the FC channel and FC protocol. Okay. Next we have is the Internet protocol, that is IP. IP is a network protocol that has been traditionally used for host-to-host traffic. With the emergence of new technologies, an IP network has become a viable option for host-to-storage communication. So IP offers several advantages in terms of cost and maturity and enables organizations to leverage their existing IP-based network. ISESI and FCIP protocols are common examples of leverage IP for host-to-storage communication. Again, this protocol we will be studying in detail in upcoming chapters. The next part is storage. The next component is storage. Storage is a core component in a data center. A storage device uses magnetic optic or solid state media. Disks, tapes, and diskettes use magnetic media, whereas CD or DVDs use optical media for storage. Removable flash memory or flash drives are examples of the solid state media. In the past, tapes were the most popular storage option for backups because of their low cost. However, tapes have the various limitations in terms of performance and management. See, let us see what are those disadvantages. First one is the data is stored on the tape linearly along the length of the tape. Search and retrieval of the data are done sequentially, and it invariably takes several seconds to access the data. Okay, so as a result, random data access is very slow and it is time consuming. This limits tapes as a viable option for application that require real time rapid access to data. Since the data access time is too much, or the data access speed is too slow, it is not highly recommended to use the tapes. Okay, so this cannot be used in applications that require real time and rapid access to the data. Next disadvantage is in a shared computer environment, data stored on tape cannot be accessed by multiple applications simultaneously, restricting its use to one application at a time. So multiple applications on a shared network cannot use tapes, as it allows only one application at a time to be used. Next is on tape drive, the read or write head touches the tape surface, so the tape degrades or wears after repeated use. So the reader write operation head touches the tape surface frequently, so that degrades or wear out the parts of that tape after repeated usage. So that is one more biggest disadvantage. The storage and retrieval requirements of data from the tape and the overhead associated with managing the tape media are significant. So due to these limitations and availability of low cost disk drives, tapes are no longer a preferred choice as backup destination for enterprise class data centers. So after that, the emergence of optical disk storage emerged as popular in small single user computing environments. It is frequently used by individuals to store photos or as a backup medium on personal or laptop computers. It is also used as a distribution medium for small applications such as games, or as a means to transfer small amounts of data from one computer system to another. Optical disks have limited capacity and speed, which limit the use of optical media as a business data storage solution. The capability to write once and read many, that is WORM, write once and read many, is one of the advantage of optical disk storage. CD-ROM is an example of WORM device, that is read once and read many times. Optical disk to some degree guarantee that the content has not been altered. Therefore, it can be used as low cost alternative for long term storage of relatively small amounts of an array called jukebox are still used as a fixed content storage solutions. Other forms of optical disk include CD, RW, Blu-ray disk and other variations of DVD. Disk drives are the most popular storage medium used in modern computers for storing and accessing data for performance intensive online applications. Disks support rapid access to random data locations. This means that the data can be written or retrieved quickly for a large number of simultaneous users or applications. In addition, disks have a large capacity. Disk storage arrays can be configured with multiple disks to provide increased capacity and enhanced performance. We shall continue this module in the upcoming videos. Keep watching. Thank you.